I'm Jacqueline, and welcome to Timeless Beauty Studio for the Mature Woman. Today I'm going to get into style tips with you. So you can take some of these tips and apply them to your own style. Remember, they're just samples and suggestions, so just take what you like, and the main thing is just to have fun with it. So let's get right into the 8 tips. So my first tip is to add some trend into your style. I know at our ages, we don't want to add too much trend in because we're pretty comfortable with our traditional styles and that sort of thing. But anyway, even to add a couple of trends in will make you look a little more current, and sometimes it's fun and you can feel good about it. So doing my research and looking in the stores and online and that sort of thing, some of the trends that are in right now, I'm just going to go through with you, and I'll put some pictures up to show you what the trends are too. So the first trend is with the, you can add accessories like necklaces, and a lot of the necklaces that are coming out are layered necklaces, and you have 2 or 3 chains, and also you will see some of them with shells, and I have shown a picture of that too. Also, some of the other trends for spring are the hoop earrings, but the thicker hoop earrings. So they're coming in metals and some acetate too. So you'll see the acrylic and that sort of thing. And they're bigger and thicker hoops. And I also did notice that we did see for a while the mismatched earrings, where somebody will wear one earring and a different earring on the other side. That's still in trend. And also, you know, with the trends, you can look at the colors. So right now, lavender, the ultraviolet is the very popular Pantone color for the year. And you're going to see a lot of the lavenders, which are really beautiful, and a lot of people can wear lavender. And I'll show you pictures of that. And I also wanted to mention that Marlena Fab and Glam is right in this year with her lavender or purpley hair. So Marlene, if you're watching, you're right in this year. Anyways, it looks beautiful on you all the time. But I just wanted to mention that because your hair does look beautiful with the purple in it. And also, we're looking at pattern, you'll see a lot of polka dots that are in. And I know polka dots and stripes can be very traditional patterns, but for trending this year, polka dot is very, very big, and I've seen it even in the store I work for. A lot of the polka dots are coming in. So enjoy the polka dots, ladies, because they're lots of fun to wear too. Okay, so number one, I was talking about adding trends. I've just named a few. I mean, there's a lot more other trends out there that you'll see, like the boho is very popular again, the fringe look. What else? Also the, tie-dye. And funny thing is, I said to my husband the other day, he has a tie-dye shirt that he got in St. Lucia. I said, well, you're right on trend this year. You can wear it this summer. Anyway, those are just a few of the trends to add to your wardrobe if, you want to amp it up and look a little bit more current. Another thing that I want to mention, another style tip actually, is number 2. And that's looking for fabrics that skim the body and don't cling to the body. And as you can see, I put some picture up of samples of fabrics that just fall nicely along over the body. They're not clinging. I know a lot of ladies are uncomfortable with that anyway. So look for fabrics that maybe are a little thicker and you can't see through, and they just skim nicely over the body. So that's another style tip for sure that I see, especially with women that come into the store. I always encourage them to, have it flow over the body nicely and give them a nice shape. So my number 3 style tip is to wear higher waisted pants. So you have a little bit of that tummy control, and you want to make sure that the cut in the leg too is appropriate for your body type. So the high-waisted pants, I know Peter Nygaard has pants that they have the tummy control in them and they come up higher, so that just holds you in. And wear a nice straight leg pant, or if you can, wear the skinny, depending on, like I said, about the shape of your body. But the high-waisted pants are definitely a good tip for women in our age group. And so that's number 3. Number 4 is to add print to your wardrobe. So oftentimes print is can hide some, bulges and little jiggly bits that we have. So print is a good option. I'm going to put a picture up of a couple of prints that I'll show you because I want to mention that to wear your print according to the scale of your body. So for instance, I'm pretty petite, so my print that I would wear is in scale to my body. I don't wear a really large prints, and I don't like to wear the really tiny prints either, unless I was like even more petite. I'm kind of average to petite. So just to show you the pictures of the two ladies that I have up here, the one with the polka dots, she's a smaller boned woman, so her print is a bit smaller. Compared to the lady I have with the dress and the pattern, she is more of a plus size, so she can wear a little bit of a larger pattern. So just keep that in mind. Prints are good and great to hide a little bit of the, little bulges that we have underneath. So the prints that I had mentioned, that was my number four tip. I'm not sure if I mentioned that at the beginning. Okay, so number five is I believe you should wear that what makes you happy. So, according to your signature style, what makes me happy is I love color and I love anything that is shiny or sparkly. So as you can see today, I have a lot of, the color is blue and bright and I love color, so that makes me happy. And also I love to wear anything sparkly. I love these dangly sparkly earrings. Plus I have my bracelets that I love to wear that are crystals, and I have some diamonds, but I'm not lucky enough to have a lot of diamonds. But anyway, anything sparkly makes me happy, and color. So figure out what makes you happy and be sure to wear that, because that just exudes from you and makes you, have fun and be more confident. Okay, my number six tip is to get rid of any of outdated clothing in your closet. So I believe if you have anything older than 5 years old for sure, it's going to be outdated. Unless it's a really basic classic piece that's, over the years it has stood in style, keep that. But I believe anything that's, retro, unless you want to wear some retro, which is okay. A lot of ladies like to do that. But I'm talking typically something maybe you've had in your closet 10, 15, 20 years. It's outdated. Oftentimes they don't fit properly. The arms and the way they fit is just not appropriate anymore. So make sure you go through your closet. And I did do a closet cleansing your closet video. I will put it up there so you can refer to that if you want to. And anyway, so clean out the closet. Make sure you get rid of the old clothes that you don't want to wear anymore because they're outdated. Tip number seven is to recheck your body shape. As we age, our body shape can change too. So, not necessarily just the addition and loss of weight that we will go through during our 50s and 60s with menopause and that sort of thing, but just make sure, any of the clothes you have fits your body shape now. Like for instance, you might, maybe you were more of a pear and then you've added more weight to the top half, and maybe your stomach, or maybe you've lost it. So I encourage you to recheck your body shape. You can go online and figure out what your body shape is, and or you can even check with a consultant and figure out what your body shape is. But anyway, I encourage you to do that because we do change over the years. And my final tip, number eight, is ladies, update your glasses. If you've worn the same style of glasses over the years, maybe 10, 15, 20 years, they're the same style all the time, look for a change in your glasses. So I do have a plan with my husband's work that I can get prescriptions every 2 years. So I do change my glasses every 2 years. You might not be able to do that, but just encourage you to see what you can find that's maybe not expensive. Sometimes there's some really good deals online. But just to show you, I do have a few different styles of glasses, and I just thought I'd show you. Now I have got these 2-for-1 and this sort of kind of sales. So just to show you the different style of glasses I wear. And first of all, I have these. These are my plastic, and these are more for fun when I'm wearing jeans, and I find I wear these more in the summer because of the colors. And They're modern, and so look for modern glasses, different styles that we have out right now. And you're also going to want to pick the colors that suit your coloring and also good shapes for your face. So down the road, I will do a video on how to pick glasses for your face shape. So if you want to see that, please let me know in the comment section. So this is the first pair that I have. And this is another pair that I just recently got. Oh my goodness, they are dirty, excuse that. So I just got these ones, and these are my black and white ones, as you can see. And I like that cat eye look, and I find the black and white goes a lot with my wardrobe. So I got these ones recently, and I don't know if I've worn any. I've worn this one in the older videos because these are my older ones. So again, these are more of a cat eye. And they have the pattern on them, which are the leopard print patterns. So they're pretty modern. Leopard print is still in for spring, ladies. So those are those. And then my last ones I got, I wanted a little bit of a dressier option. So I didn't want to have it too funky looking. So these ones here are my dressier options. And they're pretty basic, but they're really pretty. Anyway, let me know which frames you like. So update your frames because it can make a big difference with your look. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video, gave you some ideas. Please give me a thumbs up and hit that little bell and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. And I want to welcome all my new subscribers. I really appreciate you being here. Thank you so much. And I'm looking forward to chatting with you and see you in the next video. So take care. Have a great day. Bye.